You know, so much, so many times in life, I just want to feel something, man. I just want to feel something.
I don't know why we're just so mean to ourselves, man.
Oh, if I was better, if I was perfect, then I would be loved. You know, I'm not perfect enough. I'm not good enough.
Dark here, but do you remember when you were a kid and you heard of people unaliving themselves and you thought, how could someone ever do that? And then you got to be an adult.
In high school, I had sex multiple times with a girl who I knew had a boyfriend. When she finally told him, he hung himself.
Very emotional for you.
I never saw the video. I really don't know my father 100%. He was a drunk person. I never spoke with him like a normal conversation. It was hard.
It's a sadness for you.
To be the number one and they don't see nothing. They don't see to receive awards.
Keep it moving.
You know what I'm saying? Listen, you gotta be real careful, you know what I mean?
What?
Be real careful, you know what I'm saying? Be real careful. This is a new day. You know what I'm saying?
Beyonce just texted. Really mad.
Shut up.
Just checking in.
Just casual.
I still can't believe she knows who I am.
Go and call her.
No, it's okay. She said she wants me to feel safe and protected. She admires and respects my bravery and vulnerability and thinks I was selected to break generational curses that need to be healed.
What is your definition of oppression?
I don't know really how to explain it, to be honest.
You've used a word you ought to be able to...
Yeah, you're just putting me on the spot. You just want to embarrass me. And I need to tell you this now. It's not going to happen, Brian. Because guess what? I'll dip right now.
The narrative of oppression is, it's so resentful and so ungrateful and so unrealistic and so historically ignorant that it's a miracle to me that people can swallow it.
But it's not my job to school you on something that you should have learned in school. Women have been oppressed and women still are oppressed because there are literal child slaves. There are black women, disabled women that experience oppression all the time, and Native American women as well.
Native American men as well, aren't they oppressed?
I'm talking about women right now.
Honestly,
it's a little scary that you don't know how women have been oppressed in the past. Well, like, this podcast enough is showing me that sexism is still really alive.
All the buzzwords are coming out.
We value female life more than male life. We sacrifice our sons so our women and children are safe.
If the U.S. government does not want to send you to die, it would rather send me to die.
Women were oppressed in history. But so were men. If I say how were women were oppressed, you're like, I shouldn't have to educate you. Yet you've just asked me the same question. Shouldn't you know?
Women and children first. Everyone got off that plane.
And not because you can swim better, but because you're a man, you're expendable.
No, because that wasn't taught in school.
Ah, so isn't that interesting? Male oppression was never taught in school, but women, female's oppression was. Men's grievances throughout history are overlooked.
A false allegation issue.
Men are sentenced to 63% more prison time for the same crime as women.
They're less likely to see a doctor. They're less likely to have health insurance.
The family court system truly is biased against men. I mean, there's just no question about it.
Perhaps you don't even believe in male oppression.
To be honest.
You don't?
Yeah.
The vast majority of people in the feudal ages were essentially slaves. Men didn't have any rights. Most men didn't get the vote until very late. And, you know, women got it afterwards, but not that many decades afterwards. And to construe the history of the human race as this, as the pervasive oppression of women by men is it's a story invented by women who have never had a satisfactory relationship with a single man in their entire life. Not a brother, not a father, not a husband, not a son, nothing. Because if they had a satisfactory relationship, they would not be driving that narrative forward.
He's coming. He's coming. Get
I hate here. This woman. She is literally the scourge of the earth. This is supposed to be called Outlast, and this woman is the devil.
You sore losers.
We'll sit right here.
She can't do anything for herself, so she cheats.
Either go to
and that little girl's a follower.
Your flare
and she's
gun.
Just following the devil's lead. And that guy is a survivor.
Somebody's coming back out. Amber's coming back out.
Is that who's on the beach?
Yeah, that's Amber right there.
Amber's a little bitch. Look at her. Oh my god, I want a fist fight her.
You have two choices. Go to Delta or fire your flare gun.
Look, go back over there.
No,
to your...
I'm not leaving. We...
You can't beat us fair and square. You
yep.
have to cheat.
You're right, they can't. They already stole the other team's sleeping bags.
The bitch is going for the
rat!
Oh my god.
He's and that girl that was just yelling is from the Pacific Northwest. She's from Washington.
You can't live out
oh, I hate
here.
Her.
You can't outlast us. You gotta cheat and steal to win.
Okay.
You can't do it. That's why you're desperate and stealing shit.
I'm not desperate.
Everybody on this camera can see that.
I'm not desperate
I see it.
At all. I'm playing the game.
It's not
no,
the game.
This is not. This is cheating. What the f*** is wrong with you? It's cheating.
Cheating is breaking rules.
How you can't steal shit without ramifications.
There is no law here.
Yes, there is.
No.
This is America.
No, we're in the middle of Alaska.
We're still in the... This is America.
No, we're in the middle of Alaska.
We're still in the U.S. of A, lady.
Okay.
No.
I will sit here in the cold all night long.
Joel will be
no, you
soon.
Won't, you pussy.
Okay,
as
I'll
soon
wait
as reinforcements
Joel.
Come, you can get sick and wait out here
okay.
all night long.
Oh, I hate her.
I'm single, you're single. What do you say we get married?
Well, I'm glad you finally decided on the direct approach.
Yeah, well, I'm a businessman at heart.
As am I. What's your offer?
Single rich male seeks matrimony.
Primary residence?
Westchester County.
Would you be open to considering a secondary residence in Manhattan?
Central Park West?
South.
Done. Time spent together?
8 hours, 5 days a week.
7 hours, 12 hours weekends.
55 hours aggregate, specifics to be determined later.
I'm amenable to that. Children?
One.
Three.
Two.
Done. But one of them has to be a male.
I'll see what I can do. Vacations?
December, Hawaii.
June, the vineyard.
June, fine, but Hawaii.
Nope, the vineyard.
Is that a deal breaker for you?
I'm afraid so.
Me too. Well, we gave it a shot.
I'm sure you'll find a better match.
Thanks for the time.
Why? You strike me as angry, and I wonder why you're angry.
I guess I'm not sure why I strike you as angry.
You don't feel angry?
At the moment?
Mm.
Not
well,
particularly.
Okay, generally?
No, I wouldn't say so.
I mean,
most of the places that I go, look, I can tell you what my life is like. You can tell me if you think this would be a life that would make you angry. Okay, everywhere I go, I'm stopped by people. At least a dozen times a day. I would say 5 times an hour. They're often young men, but not always. Almost all of them are exceptionally polite when they approach me. They'd like to have a picture, they'd like to talk to me, and they'd like to tell me why their life is substantially better since they've encountered my work. And I've gone to, I don't know, a dozen countries, maybe more, 15 countries, and talked to at least 10,000 people who've told me that story over and over. And so you imagine what your life would be like if everywhere you went, what people did was come up to you and thank you because what they did helped you not commit suicide and get out of your addiction and stop being alcoholic and take responsibility for your life and try to put your family together.
government does not want you to know this.
If you get the woman out of the house and working, then you're going to increase the tax because girls are making more money now, and so they're taxed more. So the governments are making money, and then you're killing two birds with one stone because now you're separating the man and the wife. So the man has less authority over the wife, and they're more separated. They're not as bonded. They're not as close together. And then you also send off your kids to school. So the family is separate, and when the family is independent, the family is not strong. They're easier to control. They're easier to manipulate, and the government makes more money off of it. So the idea of me working really hard, making a bunch of money, keeping my wife at home, keeping us close, and then she's with the kids, she's close to the kids, and she's programming the kids. The government does not like that because the government does not get to push what they want to my kids.
For sure.
They make less money because my wife doesn't work, and we're just stronger and more resilient towards them. They don't like that. So that's what I've heard.
Government.
What's a movie / TV show that's a red flag if a guy's obsessed with it?
Fight Club!
It's a big egg.
Big toxic, over the top, and just an egg.
Just a trolling.
Just a big
egg.
Fuck what you know. You need to forget about what you know. That's your problem.
We're a generation of men raised by women. I'm wondering if another woman is really the answer we need. Our great war is a spiritual war.
Just let go.
Our great depression is our lives.
It's only after we've lost everything we're free to do anything.
What are the parents be looking for?
Don't trust anybody, honestly. I mean, you can't trust anybody now. Now he's having to be a father. He's a victim, and he's going to have to live with that for the rest of his life.
This mother says watching her son struggle with the reality he now faces breaks her heart.
What has this been like for your son?
It's caused him a lot of depression. He's shut down a lot.
Now she questions why this woman won't face prison time.
I feel like if she was a man and he was a little girl, it would definitely be different. They would be seeking incarceration. And I feel like because she's a woman, they're not. They're having compassion for her because she was pregnant. But I don't think they take into play, again, she was pregnant by a child. You know, that child was created from a sexual abuse.
Under terms of the plea deal the suspect signed off on, she'll be required to register as a sex offender, and the judge could sentence her to 10 years to life of sex offender intensive supervised probation. But Serrano will avoid any jail time since the DA's office dropped the original charges to a lesser charge that does not come with mandatory jail time.
What should other parents be looking for?
Don't trust anybody, honestly. I mean, you can't trust anybody now.
The Philippines, Thailand, like women can speak very little English, women that don't have education.
Tell us how you really feel. I'll have you know, my wife speaks very good English. And yeah, I guess I am a passport bro because American women aren't worth my time. You can find a better quality of woman in the Philippines. And my wife just happens to be college educated with a bachelorate degree in bioengineering. Sadly, she gave up her career, though, to be a mother. Now she doesn't have to worry about it because she's got a passport, bro, that takes very good care of her. And she loves it.
Most important step to a makeup routine. So I asked my makeup artist friend, what do you use for skin prep?
One of the best things I ever learned myself personally, being an intelligent person, give up the need to be right. Just be okay with being correct. Stop trying to win all the arguments. All the arguments outside of places where you're an expert. If you're an expert in something, yes, fight to the death. But if it's just an opinion about something, let it go.
Okay, I hear that.
Got it?
Yes.
Thanks, sis. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Can't be. How would you describe your perfect man?
Funny. Mm. He has to have a really good sense of humor.
But he can't be broke.
because that's not funny.
Now describe how you would kill that man.
I would probably make it look like an overdose.
Wow. Oh my gosh, Julia.
Yeah. You'll never know, you know?
I'm afraid to be in a room alone with you. And are you pro women killing men?
I think that if the man deserves it, yeah, why not? Men kill women all the time for no reason.
Wow. Wow. The way that you shrug, I'm terrified.
Yeah.
Should men be allowed to have opinions?
No. No. They shouldn't even be allowed to have penises.
Really? Why not?
It's just unfair.
What's unfair about it?
Okay, if I were president, I would just give guns to every woman.
Got it.
And not any guns to any men.
Got it.
Because I feel like if they can have a penis, which is a weapon of mass destruction, it can be.
Wow.
It can be. I think that women should be allowed to have the same. I think it equals the playing field. I think we wouldn't get f***ed with so much.
Wow.
Yeah.
Here. Put yourself in a lesbian's shoes. Who do lesbians date? Women. Who do they move in with? Women. Who do they get in relationships with? Women. Who do they eventually marry? Women. And I was thinking like, oh my God, I did that. I know what it's like to live with one of those fucking things. I know exactly what that, it's hopeless. Trying to make them happy. Hey, I bought you the shiny thing. Did I do it right? Huh? Trying to get them to take responsibility for their actions. Not gonna happen. The best you're gonna get is I'm sorry, but I know what it's like to be winning a fucking argument. You're winning, and then they turn it around. They're crying. You're apologizing. You're thinking, what the fuck just happened? How am I losing this shit? I had you on the ropes. You feel so dumb. You gotta go for a walk, and you're just thinking, how did I lose again? And then you figure it out. It makes you feel stupid, and then you see some bald idiot with a giant orange mustache, and you're like, you know what? Why don't you take some of that shit?
There's a new classification of child abuse that usually happens when two parents divorce or separate. One parent will try and turn a child against the other parent.
I get emails from people from coast to coast to coast and internationally raising concerns about being cut off from their children, being cut off from their grandchildren. This is clearly a significant problem.
It's called parental alienation. Researchers are calling it a serious case of child abuse, which can lead to depression and a lower quality of life. We're joined now by Tammy Shamoon. She's a registered psychologist and a co-founder of the Institute of Child Psychology. Tammy, thanks for taking some time to speak with us this
evening. Yeah, thank you for having us.
Now, I've never been through it, but I doubt it's uncommon for divorcing parents or separating parents to fight and badmouth the other parent, especially in front of the kid. At what point is it jump from just badmouthing to parental alienation?
Well, I think it's when one parent has an agenda. We're looking at a parent who has something that they want to that other parent to be taken out of the picture. And that motive comes from that parent feeling very hurt, and they feel they want to punish their ex-significant other through use of the children. So I think it's one thing for a parent to get angry and then spout something off, and it's another thing for it to be very calculated. And this tends to be more of a calculated act on behalf of a distressed parent.
Now, this you mentioned, it's mentioned, it's supposed to punish the other parent, but how this actually has an impact on children in the short and long term.
Right. I mean, biologically, children were meant to be connected to and attached to both parents. And when this happens, you got to remember, a child is half of each parent. And when a child is alienated from one of the parents, especially the biological parents, or it could be a grandparent or another person, but particularly when we're talking about parental alienation, that child is basically told that that other parent is no good. And by default, what we're actually saying is that child is no good. And that's where the trauma happens, is the child then feels there's something wrong with them inherently. Now, they may not show this outwardly at first, but as you had mentioned, we'll see issues later on down the road with things like such as depression and anger.
Sit up, never like you know it. Special pack it with the automatics. We gon' set them to heaven. Wait. Hey.
Women, in my opinion, have lost their motherfucking mind.
Like, ever since they've gotten freedom to do things, and their freedom comes from wicked people. Trust me. All the things you're able to do, wicked people enabled you to do it. So you can destroy your neighborhoods and everything. I'm talking to all women of the Western world here in America. Your freedom has destroyed not only your neighborhoods, not only the family, you have destroyed you. And because I'm saying, like, if you look at child support, the way people alter their bodies and all that shit, this is all because women have freedom. I'm telling you, the best women in the world is a woman who has followed and got direction from a man. All women that's raised by women are destroyers of the world. All women raised by women are destroyers of the world. You can research this all you want. The best, most quality women are the women who have been given the information, the game, whatever you want to call it, by a man in their life. Does anybody disagree with that?
Break up or something.
That's awesome. Much better.
Perfect. I don't even need to tell you what to do. So you're a natural. It's great.
Do the, you know, the archer.
Oh, my God.
Go on. Like Adonis. Like a Greek god. Give the camera a bit of a flirtatious look. Oh, yeah, that's really nice, actually. Hands are shaking. All right, now try and give me something a bit sexier, you know, really sort of work it for the camera. Think filthy thoughts. Really give me like a really dirty look. All right, now just sort of look at me like you're gonna make love to the lens. Think about what you'd like to do to me. What position are you in? All right, now just pretend she's not here. Hold it, yeah, hold it. That's it. Really just penetrate my camera. Oh, yeah, just penetrate me, yeah. Okay. Now sort of turn around. And sort of, yeah, just penetrate me from behind. Oh, you're a good boy.
All right, serious.
Yeah, that's it. Ooh, it's hot in here.
Oh, he's my soulmate. Everything was fine except...
Except?
He was too nice.
Congratulations. You achieved failure. Failure has been achieved, thank God. Now, the only place to go from failure is to win. You have to achieve failure. You have to take it that far. Nobody wants to go that far. It's too scary. But you know something? I got news for you. That's where winning is. It always has been. Nothing's changed since the 70s. Nothing!
Hold on, you're talking about my IQ? Your IQ needs to be correct.
I think, okay, let me ask you this. You want to talk about IQs. What is your belief of the average IQ? What do you think the average IQ is?
I don't give a frick about an IQ. All I know is I have money and I can do what I want when I want. I don't give a frick about anything. I'm smart,
okay,
I get money,
so
and I know how to make
you
money,
have the
so
money.
My IQ doesn't matter at the end of the day.
You have the money, your... But, no, I don't want to insult your intelligence. You do have the money.
Yeah,
your
and I'm
intelligence
smart.
Is on
I'm
the
not
other
school
end.
Smart, but I'm smart as hell.
In what degree?
Say what?
In what degree?
I love this picture of Sean Connery from back in the day, especially with a woman like that, when women were actually feminine, beautiful, no plastic surgery, nothing fake about them. But notice how indifferent he is. It's almost as if he does this on a regular. Okay, another beautiful woman on my lap, whatever, he's used to it. That's the attitude you guys need to have. Indifference. Women love that in a man. You're conditioned to being around beautiful women. You're confident around beautiful women. Look how enthralled she is just to be sitting on his lap. This is how your girl should be. Her energy should be like that, where she sees you as the prize. If your girl ain't ain't even doing this in any of your photos, right? She's not leaning into you. She's not adoring you, bro. She is settling. That's why this is important. That's why body language and psychology is so important once you understand it.
I'm on 9-to-5 workers. I just gotta remind y'all, this job we got, it don't mean shit. It means absolutely fucking nothing, bro. Stop kidding yourself. Stop. Ooh, yes, boss. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, boss. Come on, man. They don't care about you. They don't care about you no matter what you do. The more you work for them, the more they'll take advantage of you, bro. Do the bare minimum to not get fired and get your coins or whatever to pay bills. And eventually, do something else, bro. Don't get stuck here, bro. This shit don't mean anything. This means nothing. Fuck this shit.
Hot diggity dog. This place is magnificent.
Of 7-week-old Andrew, Trevin, you are not.
Adept is already losing the court case with XQC.
As a recap, he doesn't have to do the bond. He agreed on record. I think E was what? The no spending, no buying clothes, or no gambling. He was no, one of them was no gambling. One of them was no jewelry, but everything else was pretty much denied, or he already agreed to it. So moving forward, she not getting no spousal support. She not getting no lawyer fees. And she better hope she wins something or she gonna have to pay him out.
Does anybody want to get married?
Hey love, how you doing? I think you real pretty and I want to take you out. Can you pay my phone bill for me on a date tomorrow? Shit, bitch. What the fuck? Are you fucking serious?
If you broke, that's all you gotta say.
Man, what the fuck?
Study out today that says women become unhappy as they get older. Well, the flip side, men get happier as life goes on.
It's the dramatic moment a witness takes down a fleeing drunk driver.
You'll kill somebody!
Hi.
Oh, hey.
You are who?
Huh?
You are who?
What do you mean?
Who are you?
How long you been out here on the streets?
On the streets? About 11 years. Cool. I skipped home. Shit was, like, abuse shit that I didn't want to deal with. Well, they put me in a foster care. Like, my parents, like, died in a car crash.
Turn around. What?
What is that?
Well, it's your car.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
It's, no.
You wanted a Lamborghini, so.
Aventador? What is that?
Well, it's a Countach.
What is that?
It's a Countach. Their Countaches are good too.
How old is it? It's not even new, is it?
And like, on serious shit, I know it sounds cliche, but it's true. And like, the foster parents were abusive, and I just booked it because I was sick of like jumping around like that shit.
Most people aren't even, at least most women aren't even curious about men.
What do you mean?
Okay. Ask a woman what she wants from a man and she'll give you a thesaurus, a list, an encyclopedia. Ask what she brings to the table. You can't even write it on the back of a stamp.
She is independent and she pays her own bills and she takes care of herself.
Then she's an average adult. Like what, you expected to be patted on the back and applauded and be given awards because you're doing average adult things? She's not some bad bee. She's an adult.
Experience, the in-love experience had ended. He was a completely different person.
Ladies, the comment section of this video just shows me y'all would rather believe a fucking insane one-sided delusion than admit you might be the problem. Like, this girl described a guy who did everything. Like writing her love letters, taking care of her when she was sick. Like, there's nothing this man did not do to show her how much he loved her. And he did that for 2 years. And of course, the comment section is full of women talking about, oh, you were love bombed. Oh, that fake ass man could only keep it up for so long. Ladies, no one is love bombing you for 2 years. No one is faking their feelings for you for 2 years. What happened is for 2 years, he put in all the effort and you didn't do your part. You didn't show him that you loved him as much as he loved you. And when good men realize they're in one-sided relationships, yeah, we're fucking done.
Thanks, Bruce. I'm back here right now backstage. I'll be interviewing the fighters as they come out of the octagon.
And I said, look, just get me there, get me my friend's tickets, and I'll do it. And then I just became the commentator.
Believe in equal rights and equal fights. So if she felt like she could spar that man one-on-one, that means that she's also prepared to take a hit from a man. So I see no problem here. Women always like to talk about how men and women are equal and we could do the same thing a man can do. But all of a sudden, when that equality strikes, they don't like it.
The key to building muscle is protein synthesis and cellular repair. Skeletal muscle is made up of long fibrous chains containing proteins. Bundles of thousands of fibers make up the muscle itself. When an athlete engages in a heavy workout, this structure is damaged, causing micro tears in the muscle fibers. The body naturally repairs this damage by mending the torn fibers. The result is a muscle that's larger and stronger than before. And with each additional workout, the athlete adds bulk, strength, and speed.
I wonder, all these mornings you've been sitting in my study. Sitting. Have you had any moments of stillness? You're right, Reuben. The world does keep moving. It can be a damn cruel place. But for me, those moments of stillness, that place, that's the kingdom of God. And that place will never abandon.
Could turn you back into a stranger.
And I know you will too. Said I know.